Easter glory. You see, the problem of a composer is not so much what to say, but what to leave out when it comes to a subject like Easter. And for a long while I had this thought on my mind. It really arose out of an outline, an address that I did on the 3 days of Easter: Good Friday, the day of death, Easter Saturday, the day of mourning, and Easter Sunday, the day of resurrection. But to try to condense the greatest thoughts in the world into a small space of time allocated by our brass band music, it was not an easy thing, and I really dismissed it because I thought it was too big an issue to try to portray. You can't paint portraits on postage stamps easily. But here it was, and other fellow composers in this building will know that if there's something there, it's got to out. This is the greatest message in the world, without any doubt at all. We look at this day of death, and we see in it something of the physical tragedy of Christ's crucifixion. You will hear at the outset something of the pathetic procession that trudged its way up the Via Dolorosa, the way of sadness, which was the road that led from the judgment hall up to where Christ was crucified. And it was a sad scene. There were people jeering and actually laughing at the spectacle. Insensitive. There were women shrieking, perhaps, some in sympathy, and there was the glint of the cruel Roman armor with their spears and their swords and so on, and their horses. And you'll hear all this in these opening 16 measures. An ugly scene, a frightening sound. And we come to Golgotha, where Christ is laid on the ground and smashed onto this cross and then hoisted up like some felon. And yet, you know, that might have been a day of death and pessimism, but in reality, it was a day of optimism. And we see this shining through as well, for suddenly the music takes on a bright glint of hope, and a fanfare shines through from the distance, almost portending the coming resurrection. And there's a large victory motive. Magnificent big sound is wanted here. This also occurs in the final movement. And then we bring this first section, the day of death, to a close by a reference to the wounds of Christ are open, sinner, they were made for thee. The second movement, day of death, Easter Saturday, I don't know whether you've ever thought of it like this. This is a kind of no Jesus day. He was not. He was dead in the tomb. The disciples had forsaken him and fled, and they were in a spirit of absolute dejection. Now and again, their spirits would be raised, and you'll hear this in the music, only to be dashed to the ground in absolute despair and sadness. There is a little theme running through, and it might help you to think of a little phrase that comes in Fred Faber's lovely hymn. Together, let us look and mourn. Jesus the Lord is crucified. And then in the end of that section, we hear the hymn in its fullness to a certain setting that is made of it. O come and look a while on him whom we have pierced, who for us died. The final movement, the resurrection, of course, they didn't believe it at first. So the fanfare and all that goes with that kind of pronouncement on Easter Sunday has an element of uncertainty about it and doubt. It's almost as if the disciples are running around, not quite sure. And then suddenly it's as if the bass section and the cymbal clears the air, and once again truth is there. And a chorus of adoration comes in, quiet, almost unassuming, but warm, almost reminding us of Mary in the garden and the way she breathed out the word Rabboni, Master. I don't know whether you know or use the Easter hymn in this part of the world, but the Easter hymn in England is very famous and very much used at Easter time in particular. It here is presented very quietly, for truth sometimes makes its point quietly, you know. And if you can imagine yourself on the corner of an English village green, we'll say, with a church on the other side, and something like about 6 o'clock in the morning as the dawn is coming, symbolic of that Easter dawning, and you hear the organist just playing quietly from the windows of the church there, the sound comes through, Christ the Lord is risen today. Hallelujah. It is a great and marvelous truth. And from that moment, the music develops to portray that truth in a more full sense. We hope that through this presentation of Easter glory, you will discover the risen Christ to be here. And more than that, you will discover Christ as one who is waiting to receive you and us all into his heart and waiting for us to receive him in the fullest possible sense into our own. Easter glory.